Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about the barrier treatment process. Now, normally we don't think of a barrier as treatment. We think of absorption and diffusion as treatment, which they are, but we're really treating noise with a barrier. So it's a form of treatment, and thus there's a process involved. If anything could be more true in this case with barrier design is to measure twice and cut once, the old carpenter adage that guys in my shop use constantly, and say it to me because I forget too. But you've got to really have numbers here because everything depends on those noise numbers. The material type, the cost, the construction methodology, everything is dependent on that. So we must measure for all noise, frequency and amplitude. We've got to do it over a week because we want to see what's going on in the whole week. We want a 7-day picture of what's going on each day. So then we can look at each day. We can look at the time of the day, the largest and amplitude and the lowest frequency, because that's the one we have to design for. That's why we have to have 7 days of data, because we're looking for a specific number. We're looking for a specific relationship. The relationship is the lowest frequency of noise and the highest amplitude or strength. So that's why we have to have this 7-day map. There's a big difference in design if our noise is below 125 hertz or if our noise is above 125 hertz. Huge difference in design. It's night and day. If I showed you two drawings and said, pick the one that's below 125, it would be easy for you to do because it would be thicker. But if they were both of equal thickness, you wouldn't be able to tell the difference. And that's one of the differences in this range. So just that difference shows you there's less material, there's a different construction methodology, there's different densities, and the materials are arranged differently. Laymen are not going to be able to understand this. I'm sorry, but it's too complicated. I built a lot of rooms and measured them for noise. So we understand the relationships that go on between density, materials, noise, frequency, and amplitude. We've studied this. So the barrier that we build in any room is always a ratio of what's going on in the neighborhood. Let's say this is a room in a neighborhood. What's going on in the neighborhood? In most neighborhoods, 70, 75 dB SPL, steady, constant range. We're going to produce an 100, 100 plus SPL in the room. So we have a 30 dB, say, range of energy that we have to look at. We want to keep this 100 dB. We don't want to leak any more than 70. We really designed for this. We don't want to leak any more than 60 into our 70 number. If we stay under the radar at 60, nobody hears us. See, there's a science to this. So the barrier we build is the ratio between how much energy is going to be in the room and how quiet the neighborhood is. We have a sandwich technique. We use a wood frame. We build sandwiches based on the noise numbers, and you insert them between the studs. So you got a stud frame here. You build the sandwich, and you insert it in the stud. Now, the sandwich from the side will have multiple layers. And you can see here in this example, one graphic of a particular barrier for a particular frequency noise problem, not yours, but a particular one that we worked on. I don't remember what the one was at the time. You can see here in the graphics, different barrier sandwiches for different frequency and amplitude of problem. Look how different they are. So you turn the wood frame into the barrier. Each design is frequency and amplitude specific. The sandwich that you build is directly based upon the noise numbers. That's why you got to have them. They're critical. We won't do a noise project without them. You can guess on your own. You won't guess right. And then you're going to call me and say, how can we fix it? And then I'm going to tell you probably, not in all cases, but 90%, tear it out and start over. Boy, people love to hear that. Well, don't guess in the beginning if you don't want that response in the end, because that's just foolishness and wasting time. So barrier and CW, we have our CAW process where we build our low frequency management with our carbon technology between the studs. You're all familiar with that. Well, there's a way to incorporate the barrier and the CAW into one stud design. You need 2x12 stud frame, but we can do it. We have drawings to help you do that. If your noise falls within the space that we have to work with to stop it with the sandwiches, got to stick a carbon filter in there too that's 4 inches deep. But it all can be calculated and designed for. Barrier treatment process. I think you can see the process. Starts with the noise measurements, then the barrier design, then the sandwich build, then the sandwich install, then you seal the whole thing. Because we're building a boat. We're going to put it in the ocean. It's got to be strong enough to handle the pressure of the ocean slapping against it, the low frequencies. It's got to, can't leak. Barrier treatment process. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions, and I usually get a chance every couple days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum, and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.